and stand to your feet. You have your Bibles. You have your Bibles. We ask that you come and go with us to two passages of Scripture. The first one is the Gospel according to St. John, the third chapter. Gospel according to St. John, the third chapter. You can put a pen there. And then we're going to flip over to 1 Corinthians in the 15th chapter. Gospel according to St. John, the third chapter. Then 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. If you found one or both, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Good. Very familiar passage of Scripture in John 3. We'd like to look at one verse, and that's that 16th verse. And we've all quoted this, or we've heard it many times. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. 1 Corinthians 15. Looking at that third verse, Paul said, "For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures, and that he was seen of Cephas, then of the 12. After that, he was seen above 500 brethren at once, of whom the greater part remain unto this present, but some are fallen asleep. After that, he was seen of James, then of all the apostles. And the last of all, he was seen of me also, as of one born out of due time. For I am the least of the apostles, that am not meet to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me." You may be seated. Amen. We'd like to speak to you from a thought today. Lord, I appreciate you. Lord, I appreciate you. In this world today, too many folks act like somebody owes them something. I see and hear folks complaining all the time about what they don't have, instead of being thankful for what they do have. And we have to realize how good we have it being in the place where we are. Paul says in Philippians 4 and 11, he says, "For I have learned in whatsoever state I'm in, therewith to be content." Paul said, no matter where I am, no matter what I got, no matter what I don't have, I have learned to be satisfied. Wherever he was, whatever he was going through, he learned to be satisfied. And we too have to get to that place where we can learn to be satisfied with what we have and where we are. Amen, somebody. Where our prayer will not be, "Lord, give me, give me, give me," but, "Lord, I appreciate you. Lord, I thank you. You might not have a big house, but you have a roof over your head. Can I get some help in the house today? You might not have that Mercedes, but that Ford gets you from point A to point B. You might not have the Armani suit or the Prada outfit, but you have clothes on your back. You might not have the steak and potatoes, but if you cook that chicken right, you'll forget about the steak and potatoes. Amen, somebody. You might not have the best job in the world, but every morning the Lord gives you health and strength to get up out of your bed and get to that job. Amen, somebody. And if you can attest to the fact that some or all of these things fit you, then you have a reason to be thankful. And I want you to note this. Don't ever get to the point and think that you have what you have because of what you've done. You have what you have because of what he has done. Can I get a witness in the house? All of your blessings come from the Lord. I heard David say in Psalm 124, he said, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, and we can say that today, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, because some of us remember where we came from. Oh, yeah, we're looking good and sanctimonious in here today. But some of us can remember and not too far and not too long ago where the Lord brought us from. And I'm so thankful that I don't look like where God has brought me from. Some of us can say that. I don't look like what I've been through. Amen, somebody. Y'all acting all cool this morning. But amen. But many of us take for granted the blessings that we enjoy in our lives. There was a time when we couldn't sit in the sanctuary or the house of God with central heating and air. Amen. At one time, we didn't even have the box fans in the windows that we can sit there, but we had to let the windows up and put a stick in it that the window would stay up and then have those fans. Amen, somebody. We didn't have the cushioned pews that we sit on today, but we had those wooden boards made, those benches made by 1x4s. Amen. And if you move too much, you might get a splinter. Oh, I wish I had some help in this house today. Amen. Children take for granted having parents that care about them. Some of these children get everything that they ask for, everything that their heart desire, and they're still being disrespectful to their parents. And adults take for granted that their children are blessings from God. Amen, somebody. Get tired of hearing parents saying, you know, these children, I don't know what I'm going to do with these children. Well, you shouldn't have had them. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. You know what you were doing to get them. Amen. Some of them sitting around, I was only practicing, baby, but if you practice long enough, you're going to get it right sooner or later. The Bible says that children are a blessing from God. Can I get a witness in here? We take for granted that we can breathe on our own. Because I see folks walking around having to tote that tank. And look, don't take toting the tank lightly, because at least God gives you mobility with that tank. But we need to be thankful that we can sit back and just take a breath on our own. Y'all ain't gonna pray with me today. Amen. We take for granted that we can move on our own. Whether it's with a wheelchair, whether it's with a cane, whether it's with crutches, we still have some activity of our limbs. We're not laying in some hospital bed or some nursing home bed and we can't move. We don't even know what day of the week it is. Thank God, and I appreciate you with the reasonable portion of health and strength that you've given us, Lord. Amen. Some of us take for granted that we have people in our lives that care enough about us to make sure that we're taken care of. Amen. We take for granted that we have a God that loved us so much that he was willing to give all that he had to save us. Can I get a witness in here? And knowing all of this, I don't know about you, but it's just me. It's just me. Knowing all of this, I want to take time every now and then and tell the Lord, I appreciate you for all that you've done for me. Come on and touch a neighbor and tell him, Lord, I thank you. Amen. Somebody need to lift up their hands and say, Lord, I thank you. Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for starting me on my way. Thank you for bringing me to the house of the Lord. One more time, Lord, I thank you. That's all I'm trying to say, Lord. I appreciate you. And if you appreciate somebody, you need to show some sign that you appreciate them. If anyone ever does anything for you, you need to show them that you appreciate it. Because if you don't, sooner or later, the blessings are going to stop coming and you're going to wonder what happened. Can I get a witness in here? And see, and I'm not saying this. This is what God says. This is what the word of God says. Romans 10, 19 through 21 says, but I say, Paul wrote the church and said, did not Israel know? For Moses said, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people. And by a foolish nation, I will anger you. And then Isaiah said, who was very bold and said, I was found of them that sought me not. I was made manifest unto them that asked not for me. But to Israel, he said, all day long I have stretched forth my hand unto a disobedient and gainsaying people. What was God saying? God was saying that I have blessed you with everything you needed, everything you wanted, and still you turn your backs on me. Look at the church today. God has blessed us above and beyond anything that our foreparents ever could have imagined we could have. And still we want to sit quiet on him. Still not want to come to church sometimes. Still folks have to make us come or beg us to come or beg us to do something for the Lord. And yet the Lord has blessed us. See, and there are a lot of folks who don't appreciate what they have until they lose it and they see somebody else enjoying it. Let me take a drink on that. That man or that woman where you used to talk about was so bad and wasn't no good and all this stuff. Now that he's left you or now that she's left you and you see somebody else got him, you can't remember when they look so good or so fine. Oh, I wish I had some help in here. That car that you thought wasn't no good for you, somebody else is still running up and down the road with it. That house that you felt it was beneath you, somebody is finding a home in that same house. Sometimes you don't appreciate stuff that God has given you, and it looks good when somebody else has it. You better show God. You better start showing God that you appreciate what he's done for you. Amen. In our text for today, we see that Jesus is having a conversation with a leader of the Jews by the name of Nicodemus. And Nicodemus is coming to Jesus by night and have said, Master, we know that you are a teacher sent from God, for no man can do these miracles except God be with him. And before he could get that out of his mouth, Jesus says, you must be born again. And Jesus rocked this world when he said, you must be born again, because Nicodemus started thinking, how can I, when I'm old, go back into my mother's womb to be born again? Jesus said, marvel not that I say you must be born again. You must be born of the Spirit. Amen. I ain't talking about your flesh, but you must be born of the Spirit. There must be a change on the inside of you. Can I get a witness in here? And then he explained to Nicodemus that God so loved mankind. He loved mankind so much that he gave his only begotten son, his only child, his most prized possession. He gave everything that he had to ensure that man had a chance to eternal life. And all you had to do was believe. Can I get a witness in here? And some of you still hadn't said anything yet because you don't see or you don't feel you got anything that you should be appreciative of with my Jesus. So there's four things I want to tell you that you have to be appreciative of, or you need to be appreciative of, and then I'm going to take my seat. I'll be ending this little Easter speech. Are y'all going to be with me for that long?